Your boys are going to PAX West 2018. And would you look at that? Nintendo is too.
Go power up, dudes! Yeah!
I'm Scott.
And I'm Simeon.
We only tell you that after Simeon says, go power up, dudes. Yeah, it's the only proper response.
I guess so. You can't, like, have something boring come after that. We're going to PAX, people. We're going PAX West in Seattle next week. We'll be there next Monday.
That's right. I'm calling it PAX Prime. I don't care who cries about it.
Yeah, it's just PAX. Isn't that where they started?
Yes.
In Seattle, yeah.
Yes.
It's just PAX. Penny Arcade Expo.
So last time I got to go, and you can find coverage of, we played like Super Mario Odyssey, Runner 3, Pokken Tournament.
Some indies.
Yeah, Hyrule Warriors, Legends, Fire Emblem, Heroes, Pants, and had a...
Two animes. Yes. Fire Emblem, two animes.
I got to take my brother Tom to fill in for Simeon's place, but this year we got you.
We have the same work schedule.
Woohoo!
I'm super excited.
So we will be there on Monday, Labor Day, September 3rd. If you are going to PAX, try to meet up with us. That'd be really cool.
Spot us, spy us out, and don't be afraid to say hello. We're not like, oh, we're so important.
I
know. With our 1,500 subscribers.
We actually passed 1,600.
Did we really?
Yeah, we just flew past that milestone.
What is that, people coming from the Geno video that are angry or something?
No, probably our $20 eShop giveaway. Watch our Twitter for stuff like that.
That's better. I would rather have people come from the giveaway than from the Geno video.
Those Geno people videos are mad.
Oh, I know. If you want some entertainment... one of our old videos is what makes Geno so special.
Huh?
And literally, oh. Huh.
It's the least SEO title we've ever made.
I know. It's just literally Geno is the only thing in there that anybody would ever search for. But it has blown up this last month. Just go into the comments and watch all of the angry people that have never watched one of our videos before, will never watch one of our videos again, and are just angry for some reason or other.
It's now our third most viewed video ever.
Guys, I don't know. Maybe it was a good episode. Maybe it was. I don't know if it was.
But.
I'm not going to go back and rewatch it.
So.
Yes, PAX. Sorry.
PAX will be great. Nintendo is bringing some great games. I mean, what are they trucking with them?
Directly from E3.
They are bringing Smash Bros. Of course. Of course.
Of course.
Of course.
Because of course.
Because of course. Yes. No, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate will be there. We will be playing that. Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee will be there. You know what I was about to call them. I couldn't remember exactly how it worked.
Well, I just like how you said Smash Bros. Will be playing it. Pokemon will be there.
Yeah. Pokemon validation for playing Pokemon Go.
Yes.
Eevee and Pokemon validation for playing Pokemon Go. Pikachu will be there, and we will probably not be watching that.
Playing that.
Starlink Battle for Atlas. That might be one that we have to get our hands on. Travis Strikes Again. No More Heroes.
You better stop getting wishy-washy, because this list is almost... I put them from best to worst. So I think we... Because here's how PAX lines usually work. You get into the Nintendo booth, and then you go on a tour from all the games. So once we're in, we might as well play everything.
Yeah, we might as well.
Because how else are we going to give our YouTube channel the impressions of Pokemon Let's Go? It could be good.
Hey, maybe it is good. Maybe it is validation for playing Pokemon Go. Either way... Travis Strikes Again, that does look like a fun game.
Yes.
I'm just not into No More Heroes.
I think we can even demo it co-op. Let's try that.
Let's do that.
Yeah.
Super Mario Party, that actually looks like it could be fun. I don't know if having such a short amount of time with it will be that fun. Who knows?
From the Gamescom demo, it looks like we're going to get about 5 minigames.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
Not bad.
Dragon Ball FighterZ.
Officially pronounced Dragon Ball FighterZ.
Dragon Ball FighterZ will be there. I haven't played this game yet. It looks really good. I'll probably stink at it, but it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. That might be a game worth getting. And that's weird for me. It just looks like a really good, really fun fighting game. Right. And I like myself a good fighting game. I've never watched Dragon Ball Z or Dragon Ball or anything having to do with Dragon Ball ever, except some parodies.
I haven't even seen this game in action anywhere. Really? I've heard a lot of great things about it on podcasts, though, so I'll try it out.
It looks like a lot of fun. It's a tag team fighter, and it's really cool. SNK Heroines, another fighting game. Ooh. I'm not into hoes fighting. Maybe that's something you're into. Have fun.
Me?
I was talking to our viewers, okay. But maybe that's something you're into too, and you're just not telling me. You're like, wait, me? Are you talking to me?
I'll skip this game.
Diablo 3, I will also skip that game. Okay. I'm just not into that genre.
No. But it is coming to Switch, so that's cool. And Nintendo gave them a spot in their booth, so that's great.
That's weird that Diablo 3 is coming to Switch.
Diablo.
That's how they pronounce it in France.
Yes. In Japan.
No, that's Diablo.
That's what I said.
I thought you said Diablo.
Diablo.
So either way, it's like a 10-year-old game now.
Yes.
I don't know why they try.
We will also check out some indies, some third parties. There's lots of great stuff. We actually have a meeting.
Yeah, we actually have our first meeting as Two Button Crew in person with people.
Yes.
That is totally new.
Yes.
Besides the meetings that we had as developers of Accelerated Delivery. But right. That was still within, that was all within the confines of TVC. We've never had another company-to-company meeting.
I know.
This is crazy.
I hope they don't cancel it.
Yeah, that's happened to us.
We'll play some mini-golf. That's what Fortnite is bringing to PAX, is a literal 9-hole mini-golf course.
I love that.
That'll be fun. Simeon's going to try to enter a tournament.
Yes. I don't know why they decided to do this, but I'm so happy. I could not be happier that Capcom is putting on a Power Stone.
It might be fans. They don't tell you anything on the page. They just say there's a tournament.
There's a Power Stone 2 tournament going on, people. Power Stone 2 is one of my favorite games. It's one of my favorite. It's probably, I was going to say my favorite party fighting game, but Smash Bros. Kind of fits in that category.
Yeah.
Power Stone 2 is a very, very close second. I love that game. I own it, that game. I've been playing that game forever. I'll probably get owned in the first round.
Nope.
But I'm super excited for it.
You're going to beat all 31 other people. You're going to get yourself a PAX medal.
That'd be so cool.
We are going to miss one of the things Nintendo's doing, which is like this crazy Pokemon scavenger hunt where they're actually asking people to leave the convention center and go around Seattle and find
people dressed as Pokemon
or as a Pokemon trainers.
Both.
And get stuff. So we can't do that on Monday, but I also wanted to talk about what Nintendo's not bringing to PAX this year, because this is my second year, and besides Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and Starlink, I'm really excited for those, it seems like their showing is a lot more lame this time. They do not have a Nindies booth. Last year, they paid for a whole entire another booth that they ran with Nintendo staff, and they gave room to Team Meat, to Choice Provisions, to Yacht Club Games, to all these other developers, lesser-known ones as well, that were helping launch the Switch with their indie titles. And it was great to be able to have all those in one place. Not this year, which is sad.
Not so much.
No My Nintendo Fast Pass. Last year, if you showed that you had a My Nintendo account, you could scan your QR code at the Nintendo booth, and they would give you a Fast Pass. It'd say, like, come back here between 10 and 11 a.m. and skip the line. None of that this year. They have no pins. They used to give you pins for each game you tried out. You could collect them all. No PAX pins this year from Nintendo. They aren't showing any NES online games, which is crazy because it's coming out the month of PAX.
Yeah.
Why aren't you showing that off? And I know that they just bring their E3 demos over. But Kimishima said that they have more unannounced titles for Switch this year, and to not demo one of them at PAX seems like a mistake.
It's so late in the year.
Yeah.
It's so late. I mean, come on.
Mm-hmm. So I'm a little disappointed, but I mean, honestly, I'm just going to be getting in that Smash Bros. Line as much as I possibly can, trying out as many characters as I can.
I mean, if you cover up Smash Bros., the rest of the games are like, okay, that game's been out for 10 years.
Yeah.
But if you just had Smash Bros., it would be awesome.
True.
Like, what? Okay. What if, like, the first day, everybody else is like, we only want to play Smash Bros. And they turn all of their setups into Smash Bros. Setups so the line goes faster. That would be awesome. That I want to see. It won't happen, but that'd be cool.
I'm sure there's going to be mostly Smash setups. Last time it was like 10 Odyssey or 20 Odyssey stations and then like a couple of everything else. You could either get in line for the tour of the booth or just Smash Bros. Also, if they do what they did at E3 and Gamescom, you can either play a one-on-one match or an eight-way.
Oh, eight-way.
Eight-way free-for-all craziness. So I don't know what controllers they have there. I don't know if it's the exact same E3 build. I imagine they've added a few more characters. What are you excited to do? What do you want to do with Smash Bros. Mostly? What do you want to get out of it?
This is what I want to get out of it. I want to get out of it the feel of a few characters and the run of the game. And for that, I don't need to be in the competitive one-on-one thing. Throw me in the eight-player match. Have me get battered around and not know what's going on, except give me a little bit of a feel for the game. A little bit of a feel for Crom. A little bit of a feel for how Marth plays in this game. If he plays like totally different, I'm quitting Smash Bros. Forever.
Yeah.
Which, literally, Marth hasn't played any different since Melee, really. I mean, it's been so easy to switch from him to him from game to game. I don't know. I'm just wanting to get the feel of the game and a feel of a few characters, but not like super intense, just like a general feeling, because it's not too long until December. December is pretty close.
I know. Nerdy Owen Plays says, Pikmin 4, wish it would happen. I think it will before the Switch's lifetime is over.
It definitely will.
As for me and Smash Bros., I'm excited to try out some of the new characters. I would love to play as Ridley. I know he's in there.
Ooh, I forgot about Ridley, yes.
Yeah. I gotta land the Tipper with his tail. Then I'll be satisfied with PAX. Also, if they build Dark Samus into the demo, you know I'm trying her out.
Yes.
And I gotta win as Dark Samus. That's my goal. Any of the other new characters
It's pronounced girl.
What did I say?
You said, that's my goal. You said, it's a joke, people, come on.
So, yeah, Inkling.
Some give me pity less.
Is that better?
He actually thinks I'm funny.
Simon Belmont. Belmont. Richter Belmont. Yeah. Any new characters would be great.
I forgot about the Belmonts, too. That's... they're going to be great. Stuff.
You forget about King K. Rool?
No, I didn't forget about him.
You want to play as him?
I'll play as him in the when I get the game, but I'm not going to use that as one of my times if my time is short with Smash Bros.
If I go like one-on-one with anybody and they pick Bayonetta, I'm just going to unplug their controller. That's my plan. I don't need any of that grief.
What if it's, they won't be wireless. I was going to say, what if it's wireless? They might be wireless with cords attaching them.
Yeah, who knows?
Have fun with that.
Rachel says, I wish I had a Switch so that I could buy the new Smash Bros. Games when it comes out. Well, it's close to Christmas.
Also, just because a new Smash Bros. Game is coming out doesn't mean the old Smash Bros. Games are any less awesome.
Yep.
Scott and I have recently gone back and played Brawl a couple of times.
Yeah.
And I have loved it. I have had so much fun with it. If you've never played Brawl, go buy a Wii. If you don't have a Wii, not Wii U, don't play it on Wii U because there's bugs and stuff. Go get a Wii.
Don't play Brawl on the Wii U.
Don't play Brawl on the Wii U. Play Smash Bros. Wii U on the Wii U. Play Brawl on the Wii because it runs better. And... Yeah. Just have some fun. It's goofy, it's stupid, it's amazing.
Yeah, Crazy K says, I'm most interested in seeing how the Belmonts play. Mm-hmm. So Crazy K put that on our Patreon post, because today, when I'd normally say, hey, vote on the next game we're playing, I said, we're not playing games, tell us what you want to see from PAX, any specific characters, that kind of thing. So patrons, get weigh in on our PAX coverage, and we'll be back with a live show Tuesday, September 4th, to tell you all about it.
I don't know why I'm doing this, but...
Are you... stirring something, perhaps shaking some salt on your future defeated foes.
Yes.
I knew it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being a part of the crew.
Don't forget to leave your comments. You guys have been great and active in the chat. Keep it up.
Yeah.
And we will see you in the next segment.
See you then.
The next segment is great.
All right.
Signing out.